typical day in the universe. Another MC spits a puny verse. I try to get through my day without saying a curse, because I curse too much and such and such. I try to improve my vocabulary. I try to cut out eating meat and dairy. I want to bring back the days of the tooth fairy, because I lost my innocence. I'm young and dumb and old and wise at the same time, because I know Jesus was a rock star, and it was Elvis who turned water into wine. I want to save a kangaroo from a life in a zoo. I want to own a llama. I want less drama in my life. I think I really want to be a happy housewife.
Thank you guys so much for tuning in to the first episode of the Kyel Show. This is just like an awesome day for me. It's actually Tuesday. My first day of classes is today. I'm now a sophomore at the University of South Florida. And when you guys watch this, you'll be watching the first episode of my official web show, The Kyel Show. And what The Kyel Show is, a talk show mixed with sketch comedies. And for this part of the talk show, I'm going to have an inspirational quote every week, because my whole purpose is honestly to inspire the youth and have you guys realize that the dream that you think is crazy isn't that crazy, and it can actually be a reality one day. The other part of the show will be the outfit of the week, and that requires your participation. I want you guys to send me your outfits on Twitter and my email, and I'll actually add both of those links to the end of this episode, as well as Tumblr. The other part will be Tree of the Week, simply because I really love taking pictures of trees, and that's where I excel in my photography. Opposed to taking pictures of people, I take nice pictures of trees. And the other part will be Artist of the Week, which is my favorite, because I want to help up-and-coming artists on my up-and-coming web show. And I will look for you guys, but you guys can also submit your work, and that's how you can become Artist of the Week. The other part of the show will be the sketches. The sketches, I wrote them and I acted them myself, and the sketches are my babies. I was really nervous at first when I started the sketches, but then I realized that I have to do what I think is entertaining. My whole point of doing the show is to become an entertainer in the future, to become the host of a nationally syndicated talk show, and the only way to do that is to entertain. And I think that my sketches truly do entertain the people. I just want people to know that no matter where you started, you can work at your craft and you will become whatever you want to be in your future. The Kyel Show has something for everyone, and I'm really happy you guys tuned in. It really means a lot to me, because this is my baby and I've put in a lot of work to it, and I really hope you guys enjoy the sketches as well as the talk show. Perfect. I thought we were in love. I thought we were going to be together forever. And he calls me today. He's like, hey, we got to talk. And I'm like, about what? He's like, I can't do this no more. Your breath's like pickle juice. I know, like, don't do that to me. Like, why? I'm sorry. I love pickle juice. I can't help it. I love pickle juice. I try and stop, but I can't help it. I gotta drink it all the time, because it just makes me happy. Me drinking pickle juice is what gives me happiness, what brings me joy to life, and he said he was tired of smelling it.
Now chips, onions, squirrels. I cook up swag, swag, so swag. I'm gonna take a jock all in the spot. Face girl, I'm just mean. Face girl, swag, so mean. I am your favorite rapper. If not you, what capper? ABC, 1, 2, 3. Joe Ray, me, Kumo. kumbaya. Yeah, yeah, I lost my train of thought. I got mad skills, I need a record deal. Yum yum, nom nom, blackpeoplemeet.com. That's how I met yo mom. She like to play Donkey Kong. I swear I love llamas. My bank account got commas. I don't got much to say, just know that I'm based. And I watch for out of trace. I wanna live up in space. I selfish out my pockets. I got two eyes socket. Bang bang, cheap train. Bass girl just did her thing.
So for this portion of the web show, it's my opinion, and a very important part of TV personalities and radio personalities is having a very strong opinion. And my perspective is of a 19-year-old coming to age, finally learning who she is. And recently what I've noticed is the negativity amongst black youth. And this weekend recently, I went to Atlanta with this organization I'm in called the Black Female Development Circle. We went to Atlanta for the Purple Power Seminar. And it's a national seminar for the Black Female Development Circle. At the seminar, we actually got chartered, so we're now official organization on the USF campus. Before going on the trip, I was really scared because we're going on with 7 girls. Not scared so much, but I assumed that something bad would happen just from past experience with being with that many females. I love this group of girls, and we not only got chartered, but we also had a great time in Atlanta. And I just love the fact that with a group of 8 females, we had a great time and enjoyed ourselves in one hotel room. That's unheard of. And I just love that positivity that we're bringing amongst black females, and I think that we should bring that everywhere in the world. There's been countless times where there has been a catty remark from a black female, or even I have given a catty remark to another black female, and that's just not okay anymore. We need to uplift and inspire one another and not degrade and defile one another. My other problem that I have is people talking about natural girls. Personally, I have struggled with my hair since I was a child. I can remember wearing weaves and getting perms for as long as I can remember. And it was not until my senior year in high school that people I had went to school with since 6th grade saw my real hair when I cut my hair in an attempt to save money when I went away to school to not have to buy weave. But even when I cut my hair, I became a slave to always having to have a perm, always straightening my hair. It is a personal choice to go natural. And for people to talk bad about it, it just really annoys me. It's really ignorant. We went natural because we were tired of being a slave to weave. We were tired of being a slave to perm. And you should congratulate us for doing such an empowering step and making such a bold statement with our hair. Because me going natural took a really long time. I have been telling myself I was going to go natural for 5 months before I actually cut my hair, before I actually did the big chop. And the fact that it took me 5 months shows you how serious of a step it is to go natural. And for you guys to talk about girls who are natural and saying that going natural isn't for everyone, or saying that natural is just organized naps, is ignorant.